Hello, everybody. Hello, everyone. And welcome back again to my channel. For today's video, we're going to talk about the isolation precautions. What do we need to know and what do we need to understand in preparation for your NCLEX and examination? Okay, now isolation precautions are very important because we're going to protect ourselves from highly contagious diseases that we might acquire if we don't wear a protective personal equipment. On today's video, we're going to talk about the standard or the universal precautions, the contact precautions, droplet precautions, airborne precautions, and additional topic, which is your donning and removing of your PPE in order. Okay. Let's talk about first the universal or the standard precautions. Now, these are acquired, okay, that we need to do because these are acquired through contact with blood or body fluids and mucous membranes that we could acquire certain diseases or disorder, okay. Now, example of these diseases are your AIDS, diarrhea, Epstein-Barr virus, the hepatitis B and hepatitis K. Remember, these are their favorite, the hepatitis B or hepatitis C or example of that, okay? Now, what do we need to do with universal standard precautions? We need to wash our hands, of course, and then wear a non-sterile gloves. That's okay. Check on that. So that's for universal standard precautions. Now, let's talk about the contact precautions. These are acquired through contact with a certain microorganism that spread easily by a contact, or they are highly contagious. So when you go to the room of the client and you touch them, you need to protect yourselves. Okay, so example of this diseases are your MRSA or methyl resistant staphylococcus aureus infections, the C. difficile, like this is a form of diarrhea that is contagious. Shigellosis is also an example of gram-negative bacterial infection that could lead to fever, diarrhea as well. The VRE or the vancomycin-resistant enterococci, and the RSV or the RSV is the respiratory syncytial virus, okay? So what do we need to do here for contact precautions? You have to do wash hands, wear gloves, Nancy, and additional is wearing gown. So remember that. W, W, and W. Okay, on the beginning it's WW, wash hands and wear gloves. Here, WWW, wash hands, wear gloves, and wear gown. Okay, for contact precautions. Remember what to do, and as well as example of the diseases, they ask questions about that, okay? Next, droplet precautions. From the word droplet, these are tiny droplets that spread through coughing, sneezing, talking, singing. That's it, okay? Anything that comes from your throat, okay? So the doors can be open during, if that's a droplet, and communicable within 3 feet. Okay, now example of your droplet precautions, we have the code here, firme, okay, pneumonia, influenza, rubella, what's this? Okay, meningitis, okay, and epiglottitis. Okay, remember this, okay, they always ask this, diseases. Example of your droplet, okay? Pirmed, okay? I put it here for droplet, okay? They ask questions about it. Pirmed, okay? Pneumonia, influenza, rubella, meningitis, and epiglottitis, okay? Just droplets, okay? Now, what do we need to do for droplet precautions? We have to wash hands, wear gloves, wear gown, and additional is masked, okay? So there are four W, wear, wash hands, wear gloves, wear gown, and then wear the mask or the face shields. Four. Okay, remember that. The door can be open for the client? Yes. Remember that too. Okay, for droplet precautions. Next, moving on to airborne precautions. Now, the airborne is the worst one. Okay, so that's why to do this, we have the complete PPE. Okay, so the five PPE. Okay, now airborne precautions are microorganisms that spread in the air and remains in the air. So that's why it can transfer easily. Okay, stay in the air and spread to others. Unlike with droplet, they stay in the air for minutes and then fall down, then not communicable, okay? But airborne, they stay in the air and remain in the air and spread to others. Okay, now what are we need to consider here? Complete PPE. So wear five, okay? So we have to wear gloves, wash hands, wear gloves, wear your gown, wear mask, okay? And as well as face shield, goggles, and everything, okay? Now, you need to close the door when the client is in. Place the client in a private room with negative air pressure so it will not transfer when they talk, when they sneeze, okay? Remember that so they will not go out elsewhere, okay? And the nurse or the healthcare worker should wear the complete PPE. Okay, now example, remember this, okay? MTVSS, okay? So measles, tuberculosis, the varicella or the chicken pox, shingles, okay, and the SARS. Remember this, okay? They always ask question. Example of a scenario of the disease. So what do we need to do? We need to wear the complete PPE, private room, or negative air pressure for the client. Okay, that's for airborne precautions. Next, for PPE and donning and removing. Now, this is should be done in order. Okay, so for putting on your PPE, we have to wash hands first. After washing, then the gown, mask, the goggles, and the last is the gloves for putting on. So remember this. Wash hands, gown, mask, goggles, or the face shield, and then last is the gloves, okay? For removing, you have to do it alphabetical, okay? So remove first, GL, the gloves, GO, the goggles, GO, the gown, okay, and then mask, then wash hands, that's the last, okay, remember that, okay, removing, remove it alphabetical, okay, write it down, alphabetical, and then so you could answer it easily with the questions. That'd be all. I hope you learned from that brief review of isolation precautions and you could apply it during your preparation and examination for NCLEX. Thank you and God bless.